Hello, welcome to another module in this online course, Strategy and Introduction to Game Theory. What we are going to look at today is we are going to look at a different game. So, we've seen a large number of games or we've seen several examples of games so far, which are slightly simplistic. What we are going to do right now is we are going to start looking at slightly more refined and slightly more sophisticated games. In particular, the kind of game that we are going to look at today is also known as the tragedy of commons. This game is titled as the tragedy of the commons. It's a very catchy title. What it means is it relates to the usage, or rather it relates to a game, a sort of a game interaction between competing agents or between competing people, related to the utilization of a common resource, such as, for instance, a mine, minerals, or a fishery, or let's say a forest, or so on. So the environment for that is matter, right? So what this game is, or this tragedy, this game, the tragedy of commons, is about the usage of common resources, or rather exploitation resources such as forests, mines, fisheries, or environment, or pasture, environment with respect to the amount of greenhouse gases that are released into the environment causing environmental pollution, or pasture lands relating to the amount of grazing and also often overgrazing that leads to depletion of these pasture lands. So, what we are looking at, we want to model this sort of a competition or a strategic interaction between different agents who are using a common resource that is common to all the people, for instance, of a certain state or a certain country, such as a forest or a mine, fisheries, which are often subject to overexploitation and leading to their eventual depletion. And we are trying to model this as a game and try to understand the behavior of these agents in such a game or in such an environment. Well, how do we start with it? Let's start by looking at a simple example in which we are taking a look at the usage of a forest. Let's say there are two timber agencies. Let us consider a scenario where there are two timber agencies. Each is involved in cutting logs or cutting trees or lumbering in a particular forest, that is, or each has a license for cutting trees in a forest towards providing lumber, right? And each one can use an effort EI. So, each can use an effort EI. It can also be number of trees that are cut, for instance, the number of possible trees that are logged by these two different timber agencies. Right, and of course, the number of trees that are cut is proportional to the effort EI, right. So, we can look at two timber agencies, the effort of each is denoted. So, the effort of timber agency 1, has an effort of E 1, and agency 2 has an effort of E 2. So, we are looking at this strategic interaction between these two timber agencies, which are cutting or logging trees towards providing timber, and their actions are their efforts, effort E 1 of agency 1, E 2 of agency E 2 of agency 2, and we are trying to understand the strategic interaction between these two timber agencies. Of course, now we have to specify a payoff function corresponding to these two efforts. We already said that the number of trees that are logged or cut is proportional to the effort put in by each timber agency. So, the payoff can be modeled as follows. The payoff U 1 of agency 1 as a function of its effort E1 and the effort E2 of the other timber agencies can be modeled as E1 times 1 minus E1 plus E2. Now, of course, this requires some explaining. The first factor E1, we are saying the utility or the payoff is proportional to its own effort, because the number of trees cut or the number of trees logged is proportional to its own effort. But also the payoff decreases with the total effort put in by both the timber agencies, that is E1 and plus E2, because the payoff is also proportional, as you can see, to 1 minus E1 plus E2. Because the more number of trees that are logged by these timber agencies together, the less is left to be used in the future. So, the less is left for replenishment, which means the future payoffs are going to be lower as compared to when they are both logging less. So, this is an interesting payoff function which takes into account not only the current payoffs, it also takes into account the possible future payoffs related arising from over exploitation of a certain resource such as a forest. So, it is proportional to E1, that is, it increases with E1, but the payoff also decreases with the total effort, that is 1 minus E1 plus E2, reason being that the more effort but both of them put in together, the more trees are cut, the more trees are logged, therefore, less is left for replenishment and less is left for future use. So, this, let me just highlight the important aspects. This shows the payoff of agency 1 as a function of its effort E1 and effort E2 of the other agency, proportional to its effort, but decreases with joint effort of agency 1 plus agency 2. So, we are saying it is proportional to its own effort, but it also decreases with the sum or the net effort put by agency 1 and agency 2. The reason being, the more the joint effort put by them, the more is the exploitation of the resource, leaving less for possible future use. Similarly, now the payoff of the second agency U2, E2, remember we have to put the action of the second agency first while talking about its payoff, U equals E2 into 1 minus E1 plus E2, also again proportional to E2 and inversely and decreases with increasing E1 plus E2. So, there are two components, one which is proportional to E2, another component which is decreasing with E1 plus E2, which is the reason being similar to what we had said in the case of the payoff function of agency 1. So, as you can see, this is a strategic interaction, because the payoff for each agency or for the payoff of each timbering agency or the payoff of each logging operation depends not only on its own effort, but also depends on the effort put in by its competitor agency, right. So, this is naturally an example of a strategic interaction between these two timber agencies. What is the best, how does this game evolve? Or what do you expect to see with respect to the efforts put in by both these agencies in practice? And of course, this game is now slightly more refined or slightly more advanced compared to the other games that we have seen before, because now these efforts E1 and E2 are not confined to a finite set, but each E1, E2 can be any real number between 0 and 1. So, we are saying 0 less than equal to E1 less than equal to 1, 0 less than equal to E2 less than equal to 1, which means E1 and E2 can take any real value between 0 and 1. So, we have a continuous set of efforts that can be put by these timber agencies. So, the action sets are infinite and continuous action sets compared to the discrete action set. Remember, in all the games that we have seen previously, we had 2 players and each player had a finite set of actions. In fact, each player, in fact, most of the games, each player had possibility of 2 actions to choose from. So, now we are moving to a slightly different scenario, a slightly more advanced scenario where the set of possible actions is infinite. That is, each timber agency can choose an effort and this effort can be any real number between 0 and 1. So, this is a more advanced game, right. So, where we have an infinite set of possible actions. That also means, because we have an infinite set of possible actions, I can no longer draw the game table. So, I can, since I can no longer draw the game table, right? Because the game table, I can have only a finite number of rows for a certain finite number of actions. Because the number of actions is infinite, I can no longer draw a game table. But therefore, to analyze this game or to come up with a reasoning to interpret the behavior of the different agents in this game, I have to come up with a different framework. And that is what we are going to talk about in the next couple of minutes. That is, how to characterize the behavior or how to characterize the outcome in this particular game, which involves an possibly infinite, which involves an infinite set of actions for both the players, right. So, naturally, as we said before, that is, to analyze the behavior of any game, we have to first start by looking at the best response of each agent or the best response of each player. Well, let us start by looking at the utility function of player 1, that is u 1, to characterize its best response. We have u 1 of E 1 comma E 2 equals E 1 into 1 minus E 1 minus E 2, right, which is equal to, I can expand this to write it as E 1 minus E 1 square minus E 1 E 2. Now, I have a payoff of U 1, which is a function of both E 1 and E 2. I have to find the best response E 1 for a given effort E 2 or for a given strategy E 2 of agency 2, which means I have to maximize this utility U 1. I have to maximize to find the best response. The best response is where the payoff is maximum for a given effort E 2 by player 2. And therefore, to maximize this continuous function, most of you, as most of you must be familiar from an introductory knowledge of differential calculus, I can differentiate this utility function and set it equal to 0 to find the maximum, to find the point at which this payoff is maximum. Therefore, I am going to differentiate this with respect to U 1 and set it equal to 0. So, d u 1 by d e 1, when I differentiate this with respect to e 1, I am going to have, let me write it down here, that is d by d e 1 of e 1 minus e 1 square minus e 1 e 2, which is equal to, derivative of e 1 is 1, derivative of e 1 square is 2 e 1, derivative of e 1 e 2 is E 2, and therefore, to find the maximum, that is the effort E 1 at which it is maximum, I have to equate it to 0. And now, solving this equation, I have E 1 star, which is the best response, equals 1 minus E 2 divided by 2. So, the optimal, so the best response E 1 star equals 1 minus E 2 by 2. I hope everyone was able to follow that argument. That is, basically, we have a payoff function, which is a function of the effort E 1. To find the best response, I have to maximize this payoff function. This is now a continuous function with respect to E1, this is in fact a differentiable function. So, I am going to differentiate this with respect to E1 and set it equal to 0 to find the best response E1 star, and the best response E1 star is 1 minus E2 by 2. In fact, this can be written as E1 star equals best response 1 with respect to E2, which is equal to 1 minus E2 divided by 2. So, we have found the best response E1 star as a function of E2. This is the best effort of agency 1 as a function for a given effort E2 by the timber agency 2. So, this is the best response effort of agency 1. What do I do next? Next, I have to find the best response effort of agency 2, right, which I can obtain from the utility function u2, u2 of e2 comma e1 equals, remember that is equal to e2 into 1 minus e1 minus e2. That is its payoff, or utility function is given as E2 into 1 minus E1 E2. And remember now I have to find the best response E2, that is that E2 for which this payoff is maximized for a given effort E1 by its competitor who is agency 1 or who is player 1. And therefore, now I have to differentiate this with respect to E2 and set it equal to 0 to find that E2 where this is maximized, or to find the best response E2. Therefore, differentiating this with respect to E2, I have d by d E2 of E2 minus E1 E2 minus E2 square, which is equal to 1 minus E1 minus 2 E2, which I am now going to equate to 0. This is equal to 0, and solving this, I am going to obtain E2 star equals 1 minus E1 by 2. That is the best effort E2 star equals 1 minus E1 by 2. So, this is in fact E2 star, which is the best response of 2 given action 1 or effort E1 of agency 1. So, we have the best response of E2 star, this is the best response E2 star of agency 2 or player 2, right. So, what have we found? So, far we have found E1 star, which is the best response of agency 1. We have also found E2 star, which is the best response of agency 2. So, we have now found the best responses of both the players. Now, to find the Nash equilibrium, we of course have to find the point where the best responses intersect. Remember, Nash equilibrium is where best responses intersect, which means each is playing best response to others' action or strategy. Which means what we are saying is the Nash equilibrium is where the best responses intersect. Therefore, each is playing his best response action to the action of the other player, right. So, naturally we have found, remember E1 star equals BR1 E2 star equals BR2 E1. Now, at the Nash equilibrium, everyone is playing his best response. So, what we have is, in fact, we have E1 star equals BR1 E2 star, right? Because at Nash equilibrium, player 2 is also playing his best response, and similarly, E2 star equals BR2 E1 star. This equations hold only at Nash equilibrium, hold only at these equations hold only at the Nash equilibrium, because both the players are playing their best response. As a result, what we have is we have E1 star equals best response 1 E2 star, which is 1 minus E2 star divided by 2. Similarly, we have E2 star equals best responses 2, best response 2 of E1 star equals 1 minus E1 star by 2. So, I have a system of linear equations in terms of E1 star and E2 star. Let me write them down again clearly. I have E1 star equals 1 minus E2 star divided by 2. I have E2 star equals 1 minus E1 star divided by 2. This is the set of equations I have to find the Nash equilibrium actions E1 star and E2 star. I can substitute E2 star from the second equation in the first, and then I will have E1 star equals half minus half E2 star, but E2 star is 1 minus E1 star divided by 2. So, I have substituted. So, let us call this the second equation, let us call this the first equation. I have substituted for E2 star from the second equation in the first equation, and therefore, I have E1 star equals half minus half 1 minus E1 star divided by 2, which after simplification gives me E1 star equals, as you can clearly see, 1/4 plus 1/4 E1 star, which means 3/4 E1 star equals 1/4, and therefore, E1 star equals E1 star equals, solving this set of equations, I get E1 star equals 1/3. So, that is the Nash equilibrium effort E1 star of agency 1. What about E2 star? Well, E2 star equals 1 minus E1 star divided by 2, which is 1 minus 1/3 divided by 2. We can also see this is 1/3. Anyway, we could also have guessed that from the symmetry of the game. Therefore, we get that the effort E2 star equals 1/3, the Nash equilibrium effort. And therefore, what we have is we have an expression, we have interestingly found what the Nash equilibrium effort for both the timber agencies is. The Nash equilibrium effort or the Nash equilibrium outcome E1 star comma E2 star equals 1/3 comma 1/3. Therefore, this is the Nash equilibrium outcome, where each of them is using an effort E1 star equals 1/3, E2 star equals 1/3. That is to say that E1 star is the best, E1 star equal to 1/3 is the best effort of agency 1 to the effort E2 equals E2 star equals 1/3 by agency 2. Similarly, E2 star equal to 1/3 is the best response of agency 2 to the effort E1 star equal to 1/3 by agency 1. And since both of them are playing their best responses, therefore, this is a Nash equilibrium, that is, each one is playing the best response to the action of the other player, which in turn is the best response to the action of all the other players, right. So, this is the Nash equilibrium outcome of this game. And finally, let us calculate what the Nash payoff is. What is the payoff to each at Nash equilibrium? At Nash equilibrium, that is what is u 1 of E 1 star E 2 star equals u 1 of 1 by 3 comma 1 by 3. This we can say is equal to 1 by 3 1 minus E 1 plus E 2 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3, which is equal to 1 by 3 into 1 by 3 equals 1 by 9. Similarly, you can show that, because of course both of the payoffs are symmetric, u 2 of E 2 star E 1 star equals 1 by 9. Therefore, what we can say is that the Nash payoff or the payoff at Nash equilibrium to both the timber agencies is u 1 or u 1 of E 1 star comma E 2 star equals u 2 of E 2 star comma E 1 star equals 1 by 9, which is the Nash payoff of both these competing agencies, or the payoff to both these competing agencies at the Nash equilibrium. So, let me summarize what we have learnt in this game so far. We have looked at an interesting game, which is based on the tragedy of commons paradigm, which is basically we are looking at interaction between two companies or two agents or individuals who are using a common resource. For instance, in this example, we consider two timber agencies logging a forest for timber, and their payoff is proportional to not only their effort, but it is inversely proportional to the joint effort put by everyone together, because that leads to a depletion of the resource. This is an novel game compared to what we have looked at previously, because the efforts, the possible set of efforts by each agent is infinite. So, there are infinite set of possible actions of each player, and we used differential calculus to compute the best response at the Nash equilibrium. Each of the players is playing his or her or their best response, and therefore, we have used this principle to solve a simultaneous set of linear equations to compute the Nash equilibrium. Found the Nash equilibrium efforts to be E 1 star equal to 1 by 3, E 2 star equal to 1 by 3, and also we found out the payoff to each of these firms at the Nash equilibrium. As a last note, even though we have considered only two firms or two agents in this example, this can easily be extended to a set of more such agencies, that is more such agents or more such individuals involved in the depletion of this resource, and that will lead to interesting conclusions. I leave this as an effort or as an exercise to the people who are viewing this lecture. So, let us stop at this point, and in the next module we are going to analyze what is the outcome of this game, that is with what is the equilibrium outcome, what is the effect on the resource, and other aspects of this game, the tragedy of commons. Thank you.